In this video, we'll deploy the same application in Kubernetes using a regular deployment object along with a cluster IP service and on a virtual machine using a systemd service file. We'll also use a simple DNS record for the service discovery. The goal of this benchmark is to find out if Kubernetes affects performance of the applications. We'll measure latency using P90 percentile from the client side. Then we'll measure throughput by counting the number of requests per second each application can handle. We'll look at availability or error rate, CPU throttling specific to Kubernetes, and of course, CPU usage of both applications. I run all my benchmarks in AdBS. I use a production-ready EKS cluster for Kubernetes with compute-optimized Graviton instances to run clients that generate load, as well as to deploy Prometheus and Grafana. I have a dedicated instance group with a single M7A large node dedicated entirely to the application, so there are no noisy neighbors. However, I use pod limits and set the limit to the VM capacity, which is two virtual CPUs. I also use a standalone EC2 instance of the same M7A large type to deploy the same application using a service file. For the application, I'm using FastAPI, which I used in my previous benchmarks. You can find the source code in my public GitHub repo. Alright, let's go ahead and run the test. One of the most important metrics is latency, which I measure using P90 percentile. You can think of it as a 90% of all requests completing within the time range shown on the graph. Now, I use the same Kubernetes cluster to run both application and the clients. For service discovery, I use standard cluster IP, which resolves to the pod IP address. But even inside Kubernetes, due to routing, latency is higher than simply using a plain DNS record pointing to the EC2 instance. I didn't expect that even without any load, Kubernetes internal networking would still play a significant role. It still uses kubeproxy to route pretty much all requests when using cluster IP service. Another important metric is throughput or requests per second. We'll see by the end of the test the difference and whether Kubernetes and cgroups it uses to isolate pods affect performance. We also measure availability or error rate. And when clients start to timeout, you get a drop in availability. By the end of the test, you'll see that Kubernetes starts to throttle FastAPI as well. Now, to measure pod CPU usage, I use CAdvisor, and for the standalone application deployed on the EC2 instance, I use Node Exporter. You can see that pod CPU usage is slightly higher. What also surprised me is that even before Kubernetes starts to throttle FastAPI, you can see the same application deployed on the VM actually performs much better. Let's run the test for one more minute, and I'll open each graph for the entire test duration one by one. Alright, first we have requests per second graph. The application deployed in Kubernetes reached around 10,000 requests per second, while the standalone app on the VM reached 12,000 requests per second, which is a 20% difference. I think if you were to deploy 10 or even 20 replicas, this 20% would quickly become noticeable in terms of compute resources you need to use. Next is the latency. Here is actually the biggest difference. The latency for the application inside Kubernetes is almost twice as high as if you deploy it on the VM. Keep in mind that the clients that generate load are in the same Kubernetes cluster. So due to additional abstractions like kubeproxy, it makes it convenient to deploy apps, but definitely reduces performance. Next, we have availability with a slight drop by the end. Then we have CPU throttling. And finally, CPU usage of both applications. So I've been using Kubernetes in production for the last 6 years, and it really makes it convenient to deploy and upgrade application. But cloud providers have all the necessary components like auto-scaling groups and even rolling upgrades built in. So you don't really need Kubernetes in the cloud if you care about performance or the cost of the infrastructure. Kubernetes makes it much more expensive based on my experience. I have other benchmarks that you might find interesting. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.